What's up, everybody? This is Jay, and this video is about, was Ghost wrong for giving Tasha the squeeze? Now, a lot is going on with this situation. I'm gonna get into it. First, I'm gonna describe what happened, and then I'm gonna lead up to why it ended up the way it is. And at the end, I'm gonna give my real talk take on what was it all about. Now, if you enjoy videos and recaps with a little bit of humor and you haven't already, please subscribe and bang that bell for notifications. I'm trying to reach 30k subs by the end of the year. I appreciate all your help and support. If you enjoy this video, hit that like. Let's get into it. Now, Ghost, he's been trying to go straight for a long time. He's still hurt over the loss of Raina. He's trying to get Tariq in line. He's not giving up. He comes to Tasha's daycare to talk to her about this meeting with the school, and then he sees this Kool-Aid girl is giving her money, and Ghost right away said, "Tasha, I know you ain't selling drugs in the daycare." And she said, "No, Ghost, I ain't selling drugs in the daycare." And he said, "All right, Tasha, well, we need you to go ahead and get ready so we can go ahead and have this meeting at the school." And she said, "Well, you know what? You go ahead and do it because I'm busy. I ain't going to be able to make it." And he said, "Oh, okay. So I see that selling dope and selling drugs is more important than being there for your son." And she said, "Oh, okay. Now you see how I felt all these years," which I don't understand where she came from, but that's what she said. He was pissed. He left. So he goes to the meeting at the school with the teacher, and the teacher is giving all these high praises for Tariq. And one of the things he said is, "It's amazing how well he's doing considering he has a job after school as well." And Ghost said, "Oh, he has a job?" And he said, "Oh yeah, at your wife's daycare. We got the check stubs to give him credit." And so he's looking at the check stub. I'm pretty sure he sees that this boy is making a nice amount of money. He know Tasha was good at laundering money. So he put two and two together. He figured that she's selling the dope and got Tariq working with her. So he sneaks into her apartment. She comes in and he's saying, "Tasha, I know damn well you ain't got Tariq selling dope out of your daycare." And she like, "Damn, Ghost, why you sneak in here?" He said, "Tell me to my mother freaking face that you ain't running drugs out the daycare with Tariq." And then she got all smart in his face saying, "No, I ain't running no drugs out the daycare. And what do you mean anyway, your son? Now he your son, but just the other day you was putting a gun to his head like he was one of your corner boys that came up short. So, you know, anyway, he's my son. And I do whatever the hell I want." So she basically was coming hard at him, and he's at the tip of the iceberg right now, because he's been trying to get Tariq straight on the right path at any means necessary. And if you got Tasha going behind his back working with Tariq to keep him selling drugs, he's like extremely frustrated. And so he said, "If you don't stop, I'm going to get your business shut down, and then I'm gonna take Yaz from you for good." And so she said, "Oh yeah, well, I'm gonna go and tell them that you killed Terry Silver, because I know you did. Try me, nigga." And he said, "What? You wouldn't do that?" She said, "Oh yeah." And then that just made him blow his top, because now she's threatening to put him in jail. And so he grabbed her, put the squeeze on her, put her up against the refrigerator, got her putting her in the Harlem Shake real quick. And so he's upset, frustrated. He didn't hit her or beat her, but he did give her the squeeze. And I'm not sitting here saying that it's okay to hit women, because that's not the case. And he really didn't hit her. He gave her a squeeze and a shake. But she did threaten to scream, so he covered up her mouth so that this situation didn't escalate further. And so also, she's putting herself in a position of violence because she's in the dope game. And when you're in the dope game, a lot of the normal rules don't apply. And so then she's scared. She's crying, talking about, "You get out of my house." And she says she's going to tell. And he said, "Oh, yeah." And she says, "Yeah." He said, "Just remember, we already lost one child. If we lose another one, the blood is on your hands." and she's screaming at him, you know, get out, whatever. But he's already in disbelief right now. He's kind of not even realizing. He kind of snapped and was kind of upset with himself that he did put the shake and the squeeze on her. But at the same time, he's trying to let her know, I don't want to lose another child. I'm trying to do any means necessary to get him straight. And then he gave it a little muff, you know, to the top of the forehead to let her know that your dumb ass don't get the point, that it's any means necessary to keep this kid on the straight and narrow, and what you're doing is not helping the situation. And so he was leaving anyway, but she told him to leave, get out, and then she cried and hold her arm and this and that. And then she kind of like got her head on her hand, like, you know, out of frustration and being upset. But this is a situation that she's putting herself into now. Ghost had to go and sip on a little oil, get a little Earl juice up in him, because he was just upset that he had even did that to her. He has tried to treat her better than that, and he's upset, but she's pushed him to the limit like Rick Ross. And so he went and got a burner phone, and he went and called right away saying that she's selling drugs out of the daycare, which was a bad move because he just told her that that's what he was going to do. And then to do it so soon after the fact makes it so obvious that it was him. Next thing you know, we see Blanca come in there. J-Lo, we have a warrant. We want to check and see if you got the drug in here. And she says, what you mean? This is a respectable business, a daycare. She said, well, we're going to check. We got an anonymity. The anonymity said you had a drug in here. So we're going to check and see if you had the drug in here, okay? And it won't be long. And she said, you know what? This is harassment, okay? I'm going to call my lawyer, okay? And so then they checking around and looking for the drugs or whatever. And so next thing you know, they didn't really find nothing. And so we see this wannabe Blair Underwood come up, and he tell her, hey, we ain't find nothing. She said, okay, you go ahead and you check at the warehouse. Send the team B to go to check at the warehouse. And then Tasha say, okay, so what's going on? Y'all don't need to come back here no more. And she said, and my name is not St. Patrick, it's Green. She said, okay, Miss St. Patrick, we're going to see you later. And I wouldn't try to sue. Don't push it. You try to push it, you're going to get in trouble. Don't do it. And so then they leave. As they leave, then we see Kool-Aid was there. And so now she's spooked. And she's like, you know what, sis? I'm out of here. Me and my girls, we out. And she's saying, what you mean you out? I had this under control, girl. I was expecting this. She said, no, you may have had this one little incident under control, but this is way out of your hands. I got kids to take care of, and you do too. You need to be doing the same. Bye. I got to get this Kool-Aid wig in order. And so now Tasha pissed. Okay, Ghost, it's on. So later, it just so happened that J-Lo and Dirty Ballsacks happened to come to our house. And so they said, look, we want to talk to you about Lakeisha Grant. And then he says, look, let's just cut the bull. Let's just say we know what's really going on with Lakeisha. And so Tasha was getting spooked, but then she said, you know, we know James and Patrick Didi. Now, you tell her what happened, and we tell you what happened. Because we're going to put it away. Did James and Patrick kill Lakeisha? What you protecting him for? And she said, he didn't kill Lakeisha. And then they said, well, what did you think? First thing she thinking about is Angie. And when she was with Ghost and all of those times. When Angie is dead, number one. And two, Angie saved you from going to jail and Tariq. Like, you should get over that. And then she's thinking about how Ghost was doing things to be with Angie and this, that, and the other. When she really should look in the mirror at what part she played into all of that. And then she starts to say, well, you know, he didn't kill Lakeisha Grant, but he did kill Terry Silver, and I don't know exactly where he would be. She said, what you think about it? What you think? You telling me what you think he'd be? And she said, well, if you go to this underground garage and you go to this spot right here, there's no cameras, and I'm sure it would be perfect. And so she gives the exact location of Terry Silver. Okay, it's time for real talk right now, okay? Now, let's keep it real. For one, Ghost put the squeeze on her because he is completely frustrated with the lack of effort that she's put forth in trying to keep Tariq on the street straight and narrow path. Some is going to argue that by her working with him, that's going to help him to stay out of jail. Is teaching him how to be a better criminal, and she can't protect him if something hits the fan. If he got beef with somebody, is she gonna start to kill them? Is she gonna be handling, you know, the game, or killing people or robbing people? If the teacher decides not to pay them, how is she gonna enforce that? I mean, she can't really get in the game. She's a little woman, and she's not able to really run the game like that. And also, you're not really working hard enough. You've given up too easy on trying to save your son's soul and trying to save him from being a career criminal. Ghost is trying everything he can because he's lived the life. He knows firsthand all of the ups and downs and pitfalls and the dangers of the game. If she can't even take the squeeze and shakes from Ghost, how is she going to be able to run in the game? And people say, well, he shouldn't have put her hands on her, this and that. If she was an honest woman, yeah, but she's not. She's in the dope game. Just like when Ghost took Tariq's money and his dope, he said, you robbing me? He said, dope boys get robbed all the time. When you in the dope game, the rules are different. They don't apply. That Me Too movement crap does not apply. So when you think if somebody want to rob her because she's making money in the dope game, you think they're not going to shoot her or beat her up because she a woman? That's not how that's going to work. They're going to do whatever they want to do because she's not playing by normal square person rules. She's playing by the rules of the dope game. So anybody that's Team Tasha and they still upset that Ghost put his hands on her, you need to leave that alone, because this isn't about just he beating his wife. She's in the dope game. She's bringing his son in the dope game. He's already lost one child. And yeah, he threatened to have her business shut down and then take care of Yaz permanently. But at this point, he's the one that's living like an honest citizen, not her. And so she had threatened to put him in jail. He didn't say, I'm going to go and call to have you put in jail. And so that's the difference. And she's trying to hit him with a murder case, whereas a drug charge is not the same amount of time or seriousness as a murder case. And so I don't know, I think he just got frustrated, it boiled over. No, he wasn't right, but neither is she, and they both are in the wrong. And when you both people are doing wrong, then bad things happen, and that's what happened. And he didn't beat her up or knock her out like she may have needed, but that would have only escalated and made matters worse if he did too. So it's a crazy situation. It's sad to see him fall down to the point of having to put the squeeze and the shakes on her. But once you in the dope game, if all you get is a nice squeeze and the Harlem shake attached to it, then you winning. And so she's lucky that she dealt with him and not Rico Suave or somebody worse that wants to rob and kill her for her money, because she's not able to defend herself. So I hope that she's able to keep Tariq out, and I hope that she realizes that this was a bad choice trying to sell drugs with Tariq. And I hope they both are able to get out, especially since they don't have any connects anyway. The only person they're going to try to get is from Rico Suave, so I don't know. We'll see. I'm Jay. That's real talk right there. Also, I want to welcome y'all to my website, www.jmorereviews.com. Go ahead, leave comments on the fan forum. You can leave comments for Power. Check out other content that I have. I appreciate all your support. Also, my Patreon.com family. I got a lot of different packages. $1 a month, just $1, can of pop, can get you access to tons of new content, early access to my videos. I also do special things for you, enhance photos, put you in music video with me, all kind of special features that you get for just $1. And the more you're able to support, the better. I appreciate everybody that has joined. I've had a lot of new family members join this month, and I appreciate each and every one of you. It's been amazing.
Thanks for watching.
Please
leave a
comment.
Hit
that
like
button
and subscribe.
And
I'll see you
in
the next video.